How do I get an email address for life? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question. I've used a now defunct service for several years in order to avoid notifying my contacts that I've changed my email address. They promised me a single email address I could keep forever, except I now find that the site is working, but it doesn't allow any view of my account. The page merely says, "It works. This is the default web page for this server. The web server is running, but no content has been added yet. Are you able to help me? Help you get your account back? No. Help you avoid this in the future? Absolutely. It's really frustrating when a service promising to provide something forever goes away. Apparently, forever isn't what it used to be, and lifetime turns out to be the company's lifetime, not yours. Having a single email address you can count on working for the rest of your days is pretty appealing, mostly because changing your email address is such a pain. You'd never have to tell all your friends that your email address was changing. You'd never have to hope that they noticed and updated their address book. You'd never have to run around to all the online services you use and online shopping sites you frequent to manually update your email address. You'd never have to lose important email because someone didn't have your new, current, updated email address. Your email address is what it is and will not change unless you want it to. There are a few ways to make that happen. The one thing I can tell you not to do is this. Do not rely on the email address that your ISP gives you as part of your service. You will move to an area not serviced by your current ISP, or your ISP will change, or another ISP will buy your ISP, or your ISP will go out of business. Regardless of the reason, the one thing I can tell you is that the email address assigned to you by your ISP will need to be changed at some point. There are almost no exceptions. Okay, a better approach is a large company's email service. Google and Gmail will probably be around for a while. Hotmail email addresses will probably work for as long as Microsoft exists, even though all traces of the website have changed to Outlook.com. Yahoo? Your guess is as good as mine. AOL? Probably good for a while, but who knows? Both of these companies have gone through corporate changes that could have easily impacted their email product. Now, you can count on some of the existing general-purpose email services to be around for a long time, and you can probably guess which ones I consider the safest in this respect, Google's and Microsoft's. Paid email services are a little bit more difficult to judge since their existence is predicated on making money. Should that change, priorities might change, and you could someday get that unwelcome message that the service is shutting down. Special purpose email services run an additional risk, their purpose. Proton Mail, for example, is a fully encrypted email service that could someday be at the mercy of various governments for whom encryption is an anathema. As we've seen, such services shut down in the past, either in response to government requests or in reaction to government threats. But using a service like Gmail or Outlook is a pretty reasonable solution as long as you don't lose your account to a hack. The best solution is to own your own domain. It's not the simplest, but it puts nearly everything under your control. Just like I own askleo.com, you can purchase, or more correctly, lease, a domain on the internet that is completely and only yours. You control all the email addresses on that domain, as many as you like. But more importantly, you control exactly how and where that email is handled, and you can change it at any time. Email on your own domain can be handled any of several different ways. Domain registrars often offer email services. They become your email provider for the email addresses on your domain. Your domain host. If you choose to host a website with your domain, almost certainly offers email services. Once again, they become your email provider for the email addresses on your domain. Any other email account anywhere. Even if your registrar doesn't offer email services directly, they often offer email forwarding. Emails sent to your email address on your domain is automatically forwarded to any other email address. You then deal with your email using that other service. Any other email service that could import POP3. Most of the major email services like Gmail and others support what I refer to as POP3 pickup. These services act kind of like an email client program, picking up your email from the email service provided by your registrar or host. You then interact with your email using these major services as you like. There are other options, but these are just the most common. Here's why this approach is the best. You can change the approach at any time without changing your email address. As long as you own your own domain, your email address need never change, even though the way it's handled can be changed as needed. For example, let's say you own the internet domain, your very own domain name.com. You have an email address, leo@yourveryowndomainname.com. Your domain registrar provides basic email services. You use Google Mail to access the servers at your registrar, fetch the email sent to you, and to send email as leo@yourveryowndomainname.com. In other words, you use your Gmail account to send and receive email as leo@yourveryowndomainname.com. Now, one day, your Gmail account is hacked, or Google just makes you angry enough to want to leave, or, really long shot here, Google goes out of business. No problem. You set up that same system, only this time you use your account at another online provider in place of Gmail. Your email address never changes. It's still leo@yourveryowndomainname.com. You're just using a different provider to access it. This is what I do. Email sent to any email address that's destined for me at askleo.com is actually handled by a Google Mail account. My replies, usually typed into the Gmail web interface. The same is true for my personal email, except that it's all handled by Proton Mail. If I ever want to change, I can. If I ever want my registrar to handle it, they can. If I ever want to handle it on my own mail server, I can. If I want to switch it all to a different online service or something else, I can. All without changing my email addresses at askleo.com or at any of the other domains I happen to own. As long as I own those domains, the email addresses need not change. And most I do intend to own for the rest of my life. So, bottom line, at a minimum, never rely on your ISP's assigned email address to last. It won't. At least get yourself a Gmail account or something similar that won't change when your ISP does. Then, consider getting your own domain. It's not as overwhelming as you might think, and it's the utmost in flexibility for the future. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/306-99. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.